What's up, everyone? My name is Speedstreak, and welcome back to Danganronpa Trigger Happy Havoc. I know it's been a while since I've played Trigger Happy Havoc, but... Wait a minute. Oh, is this... It's gone. What's gone? Saiga's body? She really is gone. It's almost like there was anything there to begin with. Did Monokuma clean everything up? Every last sign of Saiga's existence has disappeared without a trace. It's just like he said. After the class trial, before we took the elevator back up, Monokuma told us.
Oh, I almost forgot. Since the trial class is over, I'll go ahead and dispose of all the corpses.
So all the corpses all the people that we've lost, Sayaka, Junko, and Leon.
What are you gonna do?
It's okay. No need to thank me. Just seeing your delighted, smiling faces is thanks enough for me.
You're sick, you know that, Monokuma? You're absolutely sick.
After all, nobody wants to look at a rotting corpse every day. That can't be good for your health.
I'll give that to you. I didn't even have time to mourn Sayaka and Junko's deaths. What about Leon? I'm sure that's exactly why he did it. It's a bad joke, a sickening dream, but I have to accept the reality of it all. I headed back to the dining hall to meet up with the others.
Wait, it's still nighttime. Aren't we supposed to be in bed or something?
Oh, never mind. Hey guys, I'm sorry I'm late.
So,
Hey, are you okay, Makoto? Do I look okay?
Listen to me!
Oh! Kiyotaka, please take it down. Seriously.
You sure took your sweet time. I was just about to go to get you and drag you back here.
Sorry. So, what happened? Was your room fixed up like you said? Yeah. I imagine it would be pretty hard to sleep with a rotting corpse in your bathroom.
Come on, dude. She was my friend.
Hey, come on.
Jeez Louise, that's messed up, man. Why would you say something like that?
Thank you, Mondo.
My room was spotless. There wasn't anything left. Like, the whole thing never happened. Okay. I'm gonna write this down. Monokuma. After class trials, disposes all corpses and erases all evidence, making it as if it had never happened.
I see.
It must be tough staying there, knowing what happened. Why don't you just stay in Sayaka's room? Well, staying there with her scent still hanging in the air, that would hurt just as much. Plus, I decided I can't turn away from her death. Okay. Makoto does not want to turn away from Sayaka's death. Makoto? Hey, cheer up. Getting depressed isn't gonna help anything, right? Well, that is pretty good advice, Aioi. Okay, getting depressed does not help. If we all work together, I'm sure we'll find a way out of here.
You got it!
So everyone, just try and cheer up and get back on track. Is that only supposed to make us feel better? Are you... Why did you say that, Bunyakuya?
Huh?
We were already working together, and yet someone was still murdered. Anyone could betray us at this point. Really, Bunyakuya? I hope it isn't you. Now that it's happened once, it's a question of when, if not the next one, takes place. Okay, now that would be something to write down. Okay. Now that someone's dead, well, someone's been murdered. Someone's been murdered. It's a question of when, not if, the next one takes place. Well, the truth is, it is Monokuma's fault. He showed us those videos! To be honest, I haven't seen Leon's video. Only Makoto's and Sayaka's. Yeah, because Sayaka made the first move! She kinda did. Made the first move. I mean, she couldn't stand being here. She want her friends. The reason why she came here is because that way she would find a way to help keep her friends together.
Well...
But if we work together against the Mastermind, no one will have any reason to do something like that. That might be a good idea, Aoi. Aoi suggests... We work... together... against... Mastermind. Nobody will have any reason to murder anyone ever again. Murder anyone ever again.
Stop talking.
Keep telling yourself that. I'll be over here in the real world. You have to be really so stern, Bunyakuya. Working together, fighting a common enemy, like it or not, it's not simple. Okay. Bunyakuya. Working together. Fighting a common enemy. He thinks it's not simple.
What do you mean?
Are you okay with this?
The Mastermind seems to be much more powerful than we ever suspected. That is true, Celeste. Mastermind... It seems... be more powerful than we suspected. It took over Hope's Peak, which was supposed to be well defended, then modified to their desire. Okay, so I'm gonna write down. It took over Hope's Peak. Supposed to be defended, then modified it to fit their own desire. They created Monokuma, which seems to be incredibly advanced, and they're providing for every need. Created
Monokuma. Seems be incredibly advanced. Providing for every need.
And the cherry on top is the execution that we witness.
Okay, cherry on top is the execution we witnessed.
Honestly,
everything has been planned down to the last excruciating detail.
Hmm. Everything been planned down to last excruciating detail. This psychopath is a mastermind.
This is not the work of your everyday psychopath. To find them may be too great of a risk.
Not work of everyday psychopath. To find them may be too great risk.
So then,
what are we supposed to do? Anyone who truly does want to escape will just have to follow the rules.
I guess that's the only way, Byakuya. Anyone who truly does want to escape will have follow the rules.
In which case, the only option is to deceive those around you and win the game. Really?
Only option is to deceive those around you and win the game.
No.
No.
What?
No what?
I can't take it.
I don't want to live, even if it means killing someone else to do it. I know how that feels, Chihiro. I don't want to kill anyone else!
Huh?
Anyone else? What do you mean?
It's because...
Leon died because we all voted for him, right? It's so different from killing... from us killing him ourselves! Huh. Now that I think about it, that actually makes sense.
Reason Leon died because we all voted for him. No different from us killing him ourselves.
But...
So,
if we hadn't voted for him, then we all would have died instead, right? That is right, Aloy. Is that what you wanted, isn't it? Oh, poor Chihiro.
So it would seem.
She's right. If you keep that kind of flame on yourself, you'll turn into a full-fledged masochist.
Okay. I can write that. I'll write that down. If you heap kind of blame on yourself, turn. Full-fledged masochist. Yeah, torturing yourself isn't good. Chihiro, listen. You're not to blame. Not you, Leon, and not Sayaka. Mastermind is responsible for everything that has happened. Okay, that is true. Mastermind responsible for everything. We had no choice but to vote. I can't even imagine what would have happened to us if we were. Oops. We had no choice but to vote. I can't even imagine what would have happened to us if we refused. And in the end, it was Monokuma who ultimately killed Leon. That's true. So don't waste your anger on yourself. Instead, direct it at the mastermind. Direct. Oh no. Direct anger to mastermind.
This is a school announcement. It is now 10 p.m. As such, it is officially nighttime. Soon the doors to the dining hall will be locked, and entry at that point is strictly prohibited.
Oops. Sorry about that. I didn't know it was on auto.
Oh, and one other thing.
What is it, Monokuma?
It was totally obvious before that you were trying to make yourselves feel better and justify what you did. See you? Don't see you. See you? That's about how much I can see you, even when you try to hide.
Really, Monokuma?
Now pay attention and remember this well.
Okay.
The burden of judging others is a heavy one to bear. So be well aware of your actions.
Seriously, that's a bear pun? Okay, the burden of judging others equals heavy one to bear. That's important.
Order and stability rely on the sacrifice and responsibility of everyone.
Okay, order and stability rely on sacrifice and responsibility of everyone. Okay then.
Okay then. Sweet dreams, everyone. Good night. Sleep tight. Don't let the bed bugs bite.
Oh, like sweet nightmares.
What was about just now?
Is he saying it's our fault what happened? That's cruel, man.
Don't fuck with me!
That piece of crap! Who does he think he is? Oh well, let's just go to bed, everyone. And so, the day drew to a close. A tense, maddening day that saw the deaths of three classmates. Sayaka, Junko, and Leon. But this is just the beginning. Our despair has only begun. Okay. Our despair has only begun. Chapter 2. Boy's life to despair? Oh, okay, so we're going to a daily life. So am I going to talk to the boys ever? I guess so. I woke up the next day to Monokuma's normal morning announcement. Then he called us to all the gym. What's he gonna do to us this time? We're practically frozen with fear, but Monokuma was determined to get us involved in his little game. With that goal in mind, he began it. Okay, this might be important. I need to write down. What?
Okay, lift your arms up and down.
Is Monokuma teaching us, like, exercise? Okay, is Monokuma teaching us exercise? Called all of us to gym.
1, 2, 3, 4!
1, 2, 3, 4! Wow, Kiyotaka is determined.
Now reach way up and bend way down.
So, this is just a regular school day?
Tighten those muscles! Let's add a little strength, a little speed to those young bodies of yours.
I guess it is. But seriously.
Doesn't this feel great, being stuck inside like this? You got sure to stay healthy. I'm out of shape.
You're the one keeping us stuck inside. That's true, Toko. Monokuma. It's one keeping us stuck inside.
Don't sweat the small stuff. That's my motto. Oh, I sounded pretty cool just now, don't you think? Did you fall in love with me? Am I just to die for? Am I just to die and write in agony for?
All those questions, no. Triple no. Because you kill, because it's all of your fault that three of our classmates are dead.
So,
why'd you call us here? Certainly wasn't just to make us exercise.
Just to make you exercise? Just to make you exercise?
Hey!
If exercise makes you laugh, exercise will make you cry. Now, if you keep doing those exercises, I will cover the secret of the assassin's fist.
If we keep doing exercises, you'll uncover the secret of Assassin's Fist. The reason why I'm writing it down is because it might be very important later.
Passed down from generation to generation, the Empire of Darkness. The power can be yours. That sounds like a kind of junk a middle scholar would come up with. It doesn't matter.
Just get to the point. Did you really call us down here just to exercise?
Hey.
Of course not. Do you think I have that kind of free time on my hands?
Okay. We did not go to the gym just to exercise. Okay, so then...
I like to make an announcement. Every time you overcome a class trial here at Hope's Peak, a whole new world will open up to you.
Okay, this is important. Every time overcome a class trial at Hope's Peak, a whole new world will open to you. So, Does that mean we get new room? We get to see new rooms? Go up the second floor or something like that?
What the heck?
A whole new world?
You guys?
It'd really suck if you had to live here forever with nothing new to stimulate you.
Yeah, that's true.
Besides, I know how you kids get these days with your ADD and ADHD. I gotta keep you motivated.
Very nice.
So go ahead. Look around you want. Enjoy the brave post-trial world until you explode.
Okay. Explore the brave new post-trial world.
Hey, where'd he go? With that, Monokuma disappeared, leaving us even more confused at when he showed up. But, oh, a new world?
Could it be?
Is he talking about a way to get outside?
That is a possibility. Possibly a way to get outside.
I wonder about that.
It seems unlikely.
Okay. Mostly unlikely.
Okay. Piece of shit!
Well, we don't know until we look.
Hey.
Whatever he meant, we had to search the school one more time. That is a good idea, Sakura.
Search the school.
You hear me?
Okay, then let's split up and start investigating. When you're done, everyone meet back up at the dining hall and we'll share what we found.
You're basically one trick pony, you know that?
Got it!
More like a stable food source. Now let's get moving.
Seeing his words as their signal, everyone scattered and left the gym.
Well, guess it's just me.
Leave this area? Yes. Well, guess it's time to explore the school and see what other secrets what we can uncover. Oh, hello. Hey there. Yasuhiro.
What the heck?
Hey, Makoto, did you see what's inside the display case?
What?
Inside the display case.
What display case?
Bad. This is super bad, man.
What are you talking about? I didn't notice anything all that weird in here.
There.
Sure. It's the untrained eye. It's nothing, but this is bad. A bad, awful, terrible trap.
For serious.
Okay, a trap.
That stuff you see up there, any god would come by and use it to send a message.
Huh?
I'm instructed with knowledge. It's an ill omen of total devastation and ruin.
Let me out of here.
I have no idea what he's talking about. So maybe I'll just leave him alone. I guess he's talking about the statues right here. Inside the display case are trophies and other items. Yep, playing championship stuff. Yeah! He probably mistook the small statues and small trophies.
Okay, let's see what we can find. Oh! I was right! The second floor is open!
Got it!
Makoto! Look!
The gate blocking the stairs is gone. It would seem a path to the second floor is opened up.
Okay.
Path to second floor is opened up.
Alright then.
You hear me?
But it's also in utmost importance to double check the areas we already know about. Just in case.
Without a doubt.
Aren't I so clever to think of that? I really impress myself sometimes.
You understand?
Well, I'll leave the school to you.
Okay then. Okay, so what we should do first is explore the rest of the school to see what we have missed. And for the girls' bathroom, can I still go there? No, I don't think I'll be able to. And yeah, I should look around the school first. Okay. Let's see here what other doors we've unlocked. Nurse office? I don't think so. Nope. Must be locked. Okay, so that door is still out of bounds. What other places? Oh, what about here? Pressing A. Okay, fine. I need to find out what my equipment meant by a whole new world. I'm tempted to sing the song right now, but now's not the time. How about you, Mondo? Found anything yet?
Yo.
I went and checked the mail hatch in the main hall just to be sure, but... So, what's the verdict?
Shit.
Just as I figured. It hasn't moved an inch. Crap. Yeah, I'd be surprised if he made things that easy for us.
Hey, damn it!
Hey!
What?
Don't make me that face. You look like a wuss. You want me to put some fighting spirit in ya? Well, do ya? No thanks. I think I've got enough for now. Thank you. Well, okay. I'm gonna look for another way out then. Okay, I'll let you do your work while I do mine. Can we go inside the store? Nope, we can't go to the store. Okay. Okay, I know that. Okay, so no looking around any other rooms. I wonder if we will be able to take a look at the other students' videos. I mean, of course, Leon's, we already saw. Sayaka's. There's the elevator leading to certain trial and death. I really don't want to go in. I don't want to see this place ever again. No one wants to see that place ever again. Seriously, if I were in this situation as well, I don't want to kill anyone either. Okay. What other... Okay, these are just walls. Oh yeah, I almost forgot that I could run. Oh yeah! Where did Detective Girl go? I wonder where she went. I hope she didn't die. Are you kidding me? Well, never mind, I mean, do you want me to go upstairs to the second floor? Just checking. Okay, fine. I'll go to the second floor. If it makes you happy. Oops. Wrong button. I just wanted to see what... Okay, that's a map. Okay. Oh, B button. Okay, it was B button. No, not that one! Crap. Okay, there we go. Now we're going a bit faster. Running to the second floor. So that we can see a whole new world. A really horrible point of view for the killer bear to tell us where to go and wanting us to kill each other. What's over here? Oh, this is it. The gate that was blocking the stairs has been opened. Gate has been opened. Is this what Monokuma meant by a new world? If so, what's up there? Well, time to walk up these stairs and see what we... Whoa! Whoa! What's with the new color? This is the second floor of the school. Maybe there's some kind of clue here. Yeah, I'm sure of it. There's gotta be something here. Okay. Second floor... color... blue. Okay. Let's see if we can look around. And we still not... and we still can't go into the girls' bathroom, right? Nope. Yeah. I would definitely be a creep. I'm just checking! Okay. Let's see what we can find in the boys' bathroom. I mean, if it's just the same thing... Okay. I wonder if anyone else is on the second floor. Yep, just looks practically the same as in any other bathroom. Yes. Okay then. Now let's check to see what else we can find. Huh. To be honest, it doesn't look that different from the first floor. Why is there a dead end hallway here? Does this lead somewhere? Wait. Oh, I thought that was a door. Never mind. Okay, so nothing but a dead end here. Oh, what's in there? Is it just a regular classroom? Because it looks like it. I wonder if what we can see what we can find here. Whoa! The baby is sleeping. Please be quiet. Oh, hey, Sakura.
I see.
This must be what I meant by a new world. Sakura... this is what he meant by new world. I should probably take a really close look around. Yeah, we should. Clock. I know it's pointless, but I can't stop looking at the clock. Even if the time was wrong, I wouldn't have any way of knowing. I really don't like that. Yeah, I don't like that either. Oh, I got another coin. Of course, the barred windows. Guess I wouldn't be surprised, but this on the second floor too. The windows here have the same metal plates covering them. Are those coins like little Easter eggs or something? Of course, the cameras are watching us. Always watching us. Yep, every single move that we make. Definitely creepy. What? Did I miss something? I thought I saw something. Must have been a door. Yeah. Okay, time to leave this room and check out the other rooms in the second floor. Okay then. Whoa! I didn't see that. Whoa! Looks like it changed to the first floor that we know. Whoa! What is that? Where are all these desks here?
Is this supposed to be like a library or something? And of course, here as well, the windows, they're barred. I don't see any other clues here. Unless I'm overlooking something. Oh! There's another door! Leads to another classroom, of course. Well, let's see what we can find in there. Windows barred. Oh, this is the library. Oh, everyone else is here. The shelf is packed tight with books, but looking at it, found library. The whole thing is incredibly dusty. Really? Looks like someone didn't take care of their books. Incredibly dusty. It looks like this library's been neglected for a pretty long time. Even though it's a prestigious high school, they've been pretty careless about keeping it nice. Yep. Okay. So we found that. What about here? Does it say the same thing? Yep. It says the same thing. Wait. Anything else? There's a thick layer of dust on the top of the desk. Who's ever in charge of the upkeep has been pretty lazy. Strange. Huh. Oh! A letter! The shelf is covered in dust, but on the shelf is a letter. The shelf has letter. What's this? Hope's Peak Academy? What? Okay, is this a letter from Monokuma? That's my guess.
Indeed.
It was buried under a thick layer of dust. It must have been sitting there for quite a while. Well, shall we see what's inside? But we shouldn't read other people's mail without their permission.
Is that right?
What we shouldn't do is leave this here without finding what's inside. That's a good idea, Kyoko. Okay, Kyoko. Shouldn't leave letter without finding out what's inside. What's inside? Okay then. I broke the seal on the dusty envelope and pulled out the single sheet of paper I found inside. I folded the paper and read what was written there. From Hope's Peak Academy Executive Office. Nope, I called it, Monokuma. Okay, this might be important. From Hope's Peak Academy Executive Office. Throughout the years, we have been committed to shaping the youth who will one day shape the world. Is this what originally Hope's Peak Academy has been originally used for? Throughout the years, we have been committed to shaping youth who
will one day shape the world.
We have a long, proud history as an institution of higher learning with full government support.
Okay. Have a long, proud history.
I think this might be a clue.
Institution of higher learning with full government support.
Our graduates enter society ready to take on active leadership roles in every major job field.
Okay. Our graduates enter society ready to take on active leadership roles in every major job field.
However, Hope's Peak Academy must now lower the curtain on its glorious history for the time being.
What? However, Hope's Peak Academy must lower curtain on glorious history for now.
This decision was not an easy one to make, but serious issues beyond our control have made it necessary. What?
Decision was not easy, but serious issues,
that's important,
beyond control made it necessary.
But make no mistake, this is not the end for Hope's Peak Academy.
Make no mistake. Not end for Hope's Peak Academy.
We intend to reopen our doors as soon as the issues forcing our closure have been resolved.
Are they talking about
Monokuma? Because I think that's what the issues have been talking about.
Doors as soon as the issues forcing closure resolved.
That being said, this is the end for now.
This is the end for now.
And I would like to personally and sincerely thank everyone for your help and support over the years. Is this someone's last will and testament? Because it almost sounds like it.
Personally, I'd like to thank everyone for help and support over years.
For now, we are awaiting official governmental authorization to formally cease operations. Okay, I'm gonna continue. Okay. Letter continued. For now, awaiting governmental authorization. Okay, the formally cease operation. Okay then. What does this mean? What does this mean? I don't know. The contents of the letter are quite interesting indeed. They are. Contents quite interesting.
It would seem
that Hope Speak had stopped functioning as a school. Hope Speak stopped functioning as a school.
So, are we in a closed down school?
And judging by the amount of dust the letter had collected, doesn't have to have happened recently. Must have been years. Or months.
Okay, by amount of dust. Not recently.
Wait, who signed the letter? If I had to guess, this letter would have to be at least a year old.
Okay. Really? Letter was a year old.
So you're saying Hope's Peak closed down for at least a year ago?
Okay, Hope's Peak closed down for a year.
Most likely, the mastermind took over the abandoned school in order to put on this little performance.
Okay. Important. Mastermind took over abandoned school in order put on little performance.
But that'll mean it was closed when I got here just a few days ago. It's true. But I didn't get that sense at all.
Really?
Plus, if the school had shut down, don't you think it would have been all in the newspapers and stuff?
Ooh, that would have been true. If the school had shut down, it would have been all in newspapers.
I mean, you're saying it could have happened over a year ago, right? But before I got here, I saw stuff up online about the school and never saw anything about this.
Okay. Looked stuff up about school. Never saw it's closing down.
So, in other words,
it must have been all part of the mastermind's plan. They lured us all in here.
But Okay. Must have been part masterminds. Plan to lure us in here. Someone could create a place to judge and execute people who could potentially be capable of anything. Okay, this is important. Someone who could create a place judge and execute people could be capable of anything. Of course, that's all assuming that this letter is real. Okay. Assuming letter is real.
However,
if it is real though, that does solve one mystery surrounding the school. Okay. If it's real, solves one mystery surrounding the school, which is the reason why there are no students here could be because the school had already closed down. Okay, school already closed down. Reason no other students. That would be a nice, simple solution. It's true. But then, what about this other part? What other part? The decision was not easy to make, but serious issues out beyond our control have made it necessary. But make no mistake, this is not the end for Hope Speak Academy. We intend to reopen our doors as soon as the issues forcing our closure have been resolved. What do they mean by serious issues? What did they mean by serious issues? That's apparently why the school had to close. Why school had to close. Is there any connection between that and what's happening now? Any connection between that and now?
Now,
if the two events are in fact connected, okay. If connected, uncovering that connection would be a useful clue on top of figuring out the mastermind's motive. Okay. Uncovering connection would be useful clue on top of figuring out Mastermind's motive. Although I can't really see any more until we find more details. So in other words, only the Mastermind knows the truth right now. That's all you have to say, Byakuya. That's true. Only the bad guy knows the truth. Only Monokuma. Only Mastermind knows the truth. Well, right now. The mastermind's motive. If we can figure out why they wanted to imprison us all here. Okay. We can figure out why they want to imprison us. Will that be enough to get us out of here? Will that be enough to get us out of here? I don't know. Oh no, not again. Don't lock up. There we go. Or what? I guess that's the end of that clue, for now. Was that a computer? It looks like a laptop. Oh. Can we check it out? The laptop looks pretty old, and it's all covered in dust. She looks old.
So?
It's broken. I tried pressing the power button earlier, but nothing happened. Crud. It's broken, huh? Too bad. I was hoping I could use it to go online and see what's going on outside, on the outside world. Dang it. Hoping to use it to go online and see what's going on in the outside world. So if it's broken, there's nothing I can really do about it. Yep, broken. Nothing I can really do about it. Well, that sucks. What is it? Lowen? Okay. It's remarkably dusty in here, and the lighting is less than ideal. For a library, it's not the kind of place I want to do much reading in. Okay. What about you, Hifune?
I'm absolutely shocked!
How come?
Damnation! We have all these books here, and not one copy of any of my works!
You really upset about that?
Well, yeah. Why would they have comics in the library? Plus, most fanfic is just
drawn by a bunch of amateurs.
You just don't get that at all.
I do too get it. And with a face like yours, anyone can tell nothing you do is worthwhile.
Say everyone you want about me, but never judge a book by its author.
You know nothing!
Now, hear this. Appearances mean nothing at all!
That might be important. Appearances mean nothing at all.
What do you see before you is nothing more than a rind that contains the meaty pulp of my genius.
Here we go!
My creations are what determine my meaning and value.
You're so full of it.
I'm used to being misunderstood. You think weak attacks like yours will drop my HP?
Okay. Those two really worry me. Yeah, I think they worry me a bit. Anything else? Nope. Guess it's you, Byakuya. But still, this library is most interesting. What do you mean by that, Byakuya? Okay, library. Most interesting. It's because of the dust? Huh? What's interesting about it?
Stop talking.
Oh, nothing. I was just thinking out loud. That's all you have to say?
Well, never mind.
Well, I guess since there's nothing else here, I guess I could just my double check on the laptop. Yep. Never mind. So can I talk to the other girl? Doko? You must be pretty happy to have all these books around, huh, Doko?
Not particularly. Nothing's really caught my attention so far.
Mm-hmm. Indeed, there's a plethora of books, it's true, but the content seems lacking.
You know nothing!
Where's the comic books? Where's the young adult section?
Huh? Comic books? Young adult? That stuff's a waste of time.
Why do you do that, Ifumi?
I see what you write, Miss Fuwaka. Fukawa, tell us as you are. Your stuff isn't any more worthwhile.
My stores are filled with true love and pure feelings. Don't compare them to that garbage of yours. Your writing doesn't even mean anything. It's just a bunch of jumbled up letters. Someone should just burn it all.
Ooh.
Oh, the lady doth protest too much, methinks. I bet you're secretly on a boy-on-boy action.
What? Boy-on-boy? I don't care if it's an anime, or comics, or fanfic, or whatever!
I'm telling
it's all filth! Throwaway comics will now be trashed and forgotten in half a decade!
No!
Just talking about it makes me sick to my stomach! I feel like I'm gonna throw up!
Okay, Doko hates... really hates... anime and young adult stuff.
You've insulted me! You've insulted my honor!
These two are really starting to freak me out. I've never seen anything like it. Okay. Ifumi and Doko have a bit of a rivalry with what they read.
Well,
I guess we've searched the entire library, so I guess there's nothing left to do but wait a minute. Okay, just leave. Let's see what else we can find. Okay, so the library's right there. I guess those seats over there are used to, you know, like, give you a helpful reading. I wonder what other rooms we have. Besides a classroom, a library. I think this path leads to the third floor. Going so slow. Time to go faster. Faster, right? There we go. Wait a minute. Oh, never mind. Let's see what's around this corner. Okay, so it's another class. Seriously, no other floor? Wait a minute. Keep thinking that there's another door. So, are there definitely only two floors? Is that it? Really? Are there just two floors? Reality isn't everything. That could be something to write down. Reality isn't everything. Okay, let's see what. Oh, I thought. Oh, it's just splotches. And just as the other classrooms, they have all bolted up windows. Any other clues here? Maybe. I guess not. I have to get out of here. So, I guess that's all the rooms for the... I guess that's all for them. Wait. Didn't I notice that door before? Yeah, okay, I didn't. That was the other classroom. But did I look around the corner here? Nope. And see if there's... Wait. Nope. Nothing. Yeah, I guess that's all for the second floor. Seriously, that's all there is? We could check out to see what other rooms that we have unlocked on the first floor. Wouldn't there be really a third floor? Oh yeah, there is! I was in a blind spot. These are the same metal bars that blocked us from the second floor. The gate's blocking my way. There's still another floor. Gate blocking another floor. Which means not everything has opened up yet. Everything not opened up yet. Well, I guess that's it for the second floor. So I was right about it being there being another floor. Guess it's time to go back down to the first floor. And down we go. Wait, what? Wait, what is that? What? A pool area? No wonder why. Oh, I totally forgot about this. This is another blind spot. There's a pool on the second floor? Wouldn't it be more obvious to see it like on the... I don't know. Why is there a machine gun there?
Just a second.
Oh, Makoto. Hey, guess what?
Guess what I found? A pool! There's a pool here! A pool! Yep. One of your favorite jobs, Owie.
Okay. Found pool on second floor. Owie really excited.
You don't have to keep repeating it. I got it.
Okay.
There's a ton of exercise equipment in the locker room. Sakura's gonna go nuts when she finds out.
Tons of exercise equipment in locker room. Sakura gonna go nuts when she finds out.
Yeah, you're right about that. Hina seems way more excited than usual.
Yeah, she's an athletic swimmer. Hina seems more excited and unusual.
But why the heck is there a machine gun here? Wouldn't that be a problem? Is that a real gun? It's not like we're at war here. Why wouldn't we need something like that there?
Why is there a real gun in the pool place?
I have no idea. Oh, floaties. There are a bunch of different pool-related items on the shelf.
Bunch of different pool-related items on the shelf.
Oh, another coin. Okay, who to talk first? Let's talk to the goth girl first. The second floor has opened up. The living area has grown, and a number of facilities are now available. Oh!
Okay. Celeste. Second floor has opened up. Living area has grown. Number facilities now available.
Whatever else is going on, I must admit, things have been made pretty much more comfortable for us.
Okay, she admits things have been made more comfortable for us.
Do you understand?
If things continue like this, the occasional class trial may not be so bad. I think class trials are bad.
But she thinks like this. If things continue, occasional class trial not so bad.
Actually, it is bad. I mean, no, that's how you think. What about you, Owie?
Okay.
The locker room connects to a pool. It looks super nice and big and fantastic to swim in.
Okay, locker rooms connect to a pool. Super nice. Big and fantastic to swim in.
Ah, I'm beyond excited right now. I can't wait to dive in.
Always super excited about the pool.
Yep. In fact, I'm kind of getting mad thinking about it.
Okay, kind of getting mad thinking about it. Yep, she does like swimming.
Why are you getting mad?
How about you, Chihiro?
Hey, Chihiro, have you checked out the pool yet? No? I don't like wearing swimsuits.
Okay. Chihiro does not like wearing swimsuits.
Why is that? Yeah, you do seem like the type might not be into that kind of thing. No, she doesn't. She's more the technical person. Technological.
She is not the type. Might not be in swimsuits.
But still, it sounds like the locker rooms here have all the exercise equipment you can ask for.
Okay, locker rooms. Have all exercise equipment. That might be important.
Maybe I'll give it a try. I kind of like to get a little stronger. You want to get stronger? I have to say, that's kind of unexpected.
Yeah.
But I'm not even brave enough to step foot into the locker room. Huh? You don't even want to go into this locker room? Why?
Okay, she's afraid to go into locker room.
It's not like I want to, it's just... Oh, poor Chihiro. I don't get it. Is she afraid of locker rooms or something?
Look, I'm gonna put a question mark on that. Afraid?
That's a pretty weird phobia, though. So, can we go into the locker rooms by any chance? I guess we can. Behind the door is the locker room?
Yeah!
Oh, and I guess you need your handbook to get into the locker rooms.
Okay. Need handbook to get into locker rooms.
Really? Whoa!
Of course!
Seriously, Monokuma? Really, really?
Oh!
Oh, look, you scared Aoi. If you want to unlock the locker room, you'll have to swipe your personal e-handbook across the card reader next to the door.
Okay. If you want, go into locker room.
This might be important.
You swipe personal handbook across card reader next the door.
Uh-huh.
However, to ensure maximum security within each locker room.
Okay, to ensure max security within each locker room.
Only a boy's handbook can open the boy's locker room, and the same goes for the girls.
Okay. Okay. Boy's handbook. Open boy's locker room. Same goes for the girls.
Here we go. And that's the bottom line!
But...
But... What if someone opens the door and then someone else sneaks in? Hmm... That's actually a pretty good question, Owie.
What... if... someone... opens... door... someone... else... sneaks in.
Anyone who commits such indecency will be punished without mercy for their scandalous schedule. Sexual depravity.
No kidding. Anyone who doesn't will. Anyone who does that be punished. Without mercy for scandalous depravity.
Oh, so that what the that's what? Seriously, why would you kill someone because of their? Never mind. See, there's a Gatling gun mounted on the ceiling, right? It'll be all.
Just a second.
I bet it really hurt to get shot by that thing. Yeah, it would be it, Owie. No, I think it'd be a little worse than that. That's true, Shiro.
Hmm.
What if someone loans their handbook to someone else?
Hmm. What if someone else loans handbook to someone else?
A boy could borrow a girl's handbook and now we get into the girl's locker room, would it not? What? That never occurred to me! To think someone could be so low, so cowardly, so devilish!
Hmm?
Hmm, okay. This sound?
I got it!
Time for a new rule! At this moment, loaning your ebook to another student is strictly prohibited!
Okay. Loaning your e-handbook to another student strictly prohibited. Might be important for a trial.
There! So now nobody can give their handbook to anyone else, right? Capiche? I like that. I'm a kind of a genius, right? It's because my brain is 100% cotton. Not straw?
Honestly.
I do not imagine anyone would have lent their handbook out in the first place.
Is that okay?
After all, they would likely be held responsible for anyone for anything that person might do using the handbook.
Hmm. Person would be responsible for anything. Person. Might do using handbook.
So,
but, you know, you seem awfully concerned with all this locker room security stuff.
Of course!
Monokuma. Extremely careful with security.
Because all you teenagers are sex-crazed men! Maniacs, you're the age that...
What? This is Monokuma. Just why do you think that way? Just why?
So, to keep anything unseemly for happening, I have to maintain a rigorous watch.
Okay. But if it... I think it's okay for you to, you know, to keep up the maximum security. To keep anything unseemly from happening. Maintain Monokuma. Maintains a rigorous watch.
Then in that case, I would ask you to keep the same close eye on our dorms. If some man and woman decide to share a room, there will be nothing to stop them.
Celeste adds on for dorms as well.
All I care about is protecting the holy image of the school itself.
Monokuma only cares about protecting the holy image of school itself.
Disgusting.
I don't care what happens in your private dorms. By force or cunning, do whatever you want!
Ugh. Does not care what happens in private dorms.
Just the worst!
I hate you so much! You said it, Owie.
See ya later!
Okay, so the new regulation is now in place. See ya! Man, that stupid bear totally ruined my mood. Maybe I'll go take a dip to cheer myself up.
You got it!
Celeste, Chihiro, wanna come with me?
As for me...
There's nothing more. There's nothing I hate more than getting water on my face. What, because you're gothic?
I'm sorry.
Sorry, I'll pass this time. Huh? How come? When you're in the funk, there's nothing better than a good swim to pull you out of it. I'm pretty sure that only applies to you. Yeah, I think so. Anyway, now I have a pretty good idea what's on the second floor. But I didn't see anything that might lead to any kind of exit or anything. Okay. Okay, good idea about second floor, but still no exit. All I could do now is hope someone else found something worthwhile. Okay, all I could hope
Okay, do now. Let's hope. Someone else found something worthwhile. Okay, I better head back to the dining hall as soon as possible. Okay, head back to dining hall. Wait, already? I guess everyone's gonna be there. Guess I'm the only one. Nope, never mind. Everyone else is here. There we go.
Listen to me!
Oh, okay. Ladies and gentlemen, how did it go? Did anyone discover any interesting new anything?
Yes, indeed.
There's a library!
Okay.
And a pool! A freaking pool! And locker rooms filled with exercise equipment!
Well.
There was not, however, anything resembling an escape route. Yep. Still no exit. Yep. She's right.
I see!
Well, hey, there's no reason to get all sulky, but to hear about my amazing discovery.
Quiet down and listen!
The warehouse and bathhouse on the first floor of the dorms are now open.
Okay. Important. Warehouse and bathhouse on first floor of dorms now open.
You hear me?
And the warehouse is chock full of food, clothes, whatever you want. And there's so much, it's insane.
Okay, warehouse full of food and clothes, etc.
So go ahead and stuff yourself to the gills whenever you like. Well, whenever you feel like.
Are you okay with this?
Keep in mind, of course, that going out at nighttime is still prohibited. Please do not forget.
Okay, going out at nighttime is still prohibited.
Yo.
Okay, and what about a freaking way out of here? You find anything like that?
What?
There wasn't anything in the warehouse that we could use to get our butts out of here? Nothing! Unfortunately, no. Not that what I saw. I'm sorry,
Kate. Hey, come on!
Ugh, you freaking people.
What?
Who gives a crap if we have a freaking pool now? Or a warehouse, or whatever the crap.
Stop fucking
around!
We're
still trapped in this piece of crap school! We need to find a freaking way out!
Mondo's right. Still need to find a way out.
Now, there's no point in taking your anger out on us. Adaption is the key, yes? For now, we must find a way to enjoy our current situation.
Adaption is the key.
You piece of...
Whatever you say, you frickin' loon. For now, let's just continue our investigation and let everyone know if you should discover something.
So then,
are we done for today?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I guess so.
The air seemed to grow suddenly heavy again. Was this the mastermind's plan? To give us hope just to turn around and betray that hope?
Mastermind's plan. To give us hope. Just turn around and betray that hope. Wait, alright, nighttime? Okay. Okay, Monokuma.
This is a school announcement. It is now 10 p.m. Mm-hmm. As such, it is officially nighttime.
Yep.
Soon the doors to the dining hall will be locked, and entry at that point is strictly prohibited.
Okay, then.
Okay, then. Sweet dreams, everyone. Good night. Sleep tight. Don't let the bed bugs bite.
Okay. Quit saying the same thing you do every single day. We all promised not to leave our rooms during nighttime. There's not much else to do. I guess I'll just go to bed. Yep. Well, back to the Monokuma Theater. What are those? Scissors?
Mr. Monokuma, do you have a second? I don't really like myself. I don't have any kind of skill or hobby I can say I'm super good at. And my grades are totally average too. My reflexes are okay. Not great. Not awful. I could get into a decent college, or I'd make a few friends, maybe even find a normal girlfriend. Which is exactly why I don't like who I am. I understand that now. My life is just one giant copy-paste. I don't have any imagination. I'm a perfectly average cardboard cutout.
You see what I mean, right, Mr. Monokuma?
Really?
Is he talking to himself? Because it looks like it. Yep, rise and shine. Same announcement.
Good morning, everyone. It is now 7 a.m. and nighttime is officially over. Time to rise and shine. Get ready to greet another beautiful day. Oh, that's right.
What is it?
I wanted to let you know that your e-handbooks have been updated.
Okay, e-handbooks have been updated.
New regulations have been added, so please take a look and enjoy your school life more than ever before.
Regulations. New rules have been added to the regulations menu. I should take a look at that. It must be referred to yesterday. Loaning your e-handbook to another student is strictly prohibited. But right now, I must hurry up and head to breakfast. Yeah, I need to do that. I'm starving. Yes, I want to leave the area. I'm hungry. I need to get food. I need to drink coffee. And there's my sign again. Okay. Now let's run. Wait a minute. Which place is the warehouse? Okay, so that's the bathhouse right there. I can't see. Wait, can I go in here? Taka was right. We can really get in here now. But the others must be waiting for me in the dining hall. Yep. Breakfast comes first. The most important meal of day. Okay, I know. Turn around very slowly. Ignore that. Hurry up. Breakfast time. Let's get breakfast in our tummies. Hopefully everyone is still there. All 12 of us.
Let's see here.
Hey, Makoto.
Morning, Makoto. Well, hey, Aoi. Good morning. Is everyone here already?
Yo, yo, yo.
Nope, still waiting for Byakuya and Taka. Oh, no. Byakuya is no surprise. What's strange, Taka's not here yet. Taka? No way, Taka. I imagine he's trying to get the King of Tardiness up and out of bed. I'm sure they'll be here soon enough. Just be patient.
Let's see.
I don't mind waiting for them, but there is one problem. Which is... I'm thirsty. And get yourself
a
drink.
Come on.
How the heck is that a problem? Hey, Fumi. When you make me some tea, go make it yourself. Huh? Milk tea, if you please.
Well...
why me?
Let's see.
Your roundish figure reminds me of the owner of the coffee shop I used to frequent. That's your reason?
This is fine.
I can feel my throat dry now. Quickly, please. Please. Ahem.
Oh.
Okay. Apparently unable to refuse Celeste's order, Hifumi skulked his way into the kitchen. A few minutes later... Oh, he's back.
Thank you for waiting!
Hifumi reappeared with a tray in hand, a gentle aroma growing stronger as he approached. Finally! You could have made some for the rest of us, you know?
There's no way to think about this in a common sense kind of way.
I'm frankly declining. You're not my type at all. It's all about the law of casualty. Basic instinct. Act and react.
Now then, if you don't mind. A small smile played across her lips as she held the teacup delicately in her hand.
Oh!
Wait! She cocked her head to the side and threw the cup as hard as she could at the wall? What? Why would she do that? If she was thirsty, why would she throw her drink on the wall?
What?
Right there! Hey! What are you doing, my little white rabbit?
What?
I hate this kind of tea!
I don't understand.
Yes, indeed.
Imagine we're at a coffee shop. Just any normal, everyday cafe. I sit down and order some tea. Then they ask me, would you like lemon or milk? Now further imagine that. Yes, I would like milk tea, please. In this case, along with my tea, they may bring me a small container of milk. Yes? But this is not for me. I'm among those who prefer milk to be part of the process from the outset. The fragrance is just so overwhelmingly sweet that way. Adding milk or lemon right before you drink is like dousing your fries in ketchup. Mere condiments. Whenever looking for a cafe, I must first review their menu to see if it offers the proper style of milk tea. And I can't acknowledge any milk tea that does not add the milk during the brewing process. If I had described our shared reaction of what we just heard... Okay. Describe reaction... to what we heard about Celeste's complaint. I have to go with wide-eyed bewilderment. Wide-eyed bewilderment.
I went to all that trouble to make you that tea? And you want me to need to go even farther?
Yes, I realize it could be a bit of a hassle. Even if cafes that offer proper milk tea, it's always more expensive than simple tea with milk. It takes more time to prepare, surely, but... Why even bother creating a menu if you're not going to offer the highest level of quality?
Well,
we don't actually have a menu.
You little bitch!
Whoa! What? Okay, I didn't expect her to get this mad.
It doesn't matter! Hurry up up and bring me what I asked for, swine!
Say what?
What? Yeah! Okay! Your pinky will bring it out right now! Right now! I do so love... Coercion?
I think that's how you pronounce it. Coercion?
Huh?
You were like a totally different person just now.
Yeah, crap. You really went psycho there.
I really knew there was more to her than when I first met her. I hate to have her as an enemy. Okay. There's more to Celeste than when I first met her. Hate to have her as an enemy.
Seriously, man, she's one scary girl.
The dining hall doors flew open, and one of the late rivals came storming in.
But... Bad news, everyone. There's a mystery afoot.
What is it, Taka? Kyotaka. Mystery afoot.
Huh? What happened?
It would seem that Byakuya refuses to leave his room. Why would Byakuya refuse to leave his room? Uh-oh. I hope he isn't dead. I stood there pressing his doorbell over and over and over, but he never showed himself. Maybe he just wasn't there. I think so, but I'm worried something might have happened to him. Yeah, I'm worried too. I don't want another student to die. Something might have happened to Byakuya. When he meant by that, he didn't have to say anything else. Everyone understood exactly what that might mean. Everyone understood exactly what that might mean. It might be a good idea if we all split up and go look for him. Good idea if we split up and look for him.
Listen to me!
Ah! I was just about to suggest the same thing!
What's your problem?
Stop trying to one-up everyone. Okay then I'll go check his room one more time. I'm just gonna keep hammering that button until I get a response.
Well then,
the rest of us can go check the rest of the building.
Yeah, before it's, you know, too late.
Anyway, we just have to do our best to find Byakuya.
So where might Byakuya have gone? Maybe he went to check out the second floor of the school again. Might check second floor again.
Might be it. Might need to hurry over there. 1 minute. I wanna see what he's doing. Well, everything is still here. Hey, Fumi.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, Master Naegi. What's going on?
Well, nobody's seen Byakuya this morning, so we've all decided to go look for him.
What?
That's not good at all!
However,
it's a little picky news, too. I've only had it deliver a proper milk tea to my master.
Okay, Hifumi has holy edict. Is that like a holy mission? Deliver proper milk tea to Celeste.
To bless this unserving swine with such honor, I will serve you with all my heart and soul!
Okay, good luck with that. Ifumi's created some creepy alternate reality for himself. Yeah. I might be a bit concerned about that. Well, anyways, let's see if we can check out the second floor again. Oh, if I'm starting to think. If Byakuya had left his dorm room, after 10 p.m., that would be bad. Really, really bad. Wait a minute. Is there another way to get to the second floor from here? I thought there was one. I want to talk to the other people first. Hey, Hina, any luck? Nah, it's no use. I keep banging on this door and nothing. Come on already, open up! Careful, you're gonna bust the door down hitting it that hard. Relax, it's just nothing compared to what Sakura could do. Oh, Sakura's really awesome, you know. If she really wanted to, she could tear this door to shreds. I see. Okay. Well, she is the ultimate martial artist. She might actually be able to do it. I've been knocking long enough. I think I can say for sure he's not here. Okay. Byakuya, not in his room. I think you're right. Okay. I'm gonna look around for him.
Yeah!
Okay, good luck!
What about you, Toko? Any luck on your end? Hey, Toko, hanging out with Hina, huh?
What's your problem?
What? You got a problem with that?
Oh, no, I don't.
Something might have happened, right? Being alone right now might not be safe.
Okay, then. Just do what you think's best, okay?
So you got scared and decided to stay close to Hina.
I guess everyone has a softer side.
As long as I'm with the sports idiot, if something does happen, I'm sure she'd jump in without thinking and take the fall. Huh? Were you eavesdropping? Awful! You're just awful! Get lost, you stray cat!
Okay, then. Okay. Moving on. I wonder what everyone else has found about Byakuya's absence. Time to look around here. Wait. Oh, that's another way to the second floor? This is another way to the second floor? Or is this a completely different floor? Yeah, it looks like it. I heard this will open up at some point. Maybe. I could check out the warehouse and the bathhouse. Maybe Byakuya must have... I don't know. I mean, he might be up in the second floor. Whoa! So this is the warehouse. Hello, Kiyotaka. Aha! I see you came to search this area as well, Makoto. But you were one step too late. I've already finished my investigation, and there was no trace of Byakuya here. Okay. Not in warehouse.
You hear me?
An army marches on its stomach, as they say.
In other words...
So I thought maybe he would come here to have his fill. You must all eat. Eat until there's nothing left to eat.
You understand?
Anyway, there's no... Now is no time to get discouraged. We must head elsewhere to continue our search. Yeah, you're right. Okay, then exit out of here. Yeah, I can tell there's detergent and everything. Let's see what else. I'm just gonna talk to the other students to see what they have uncovered before heading to the second floor. So, no one's here? Maybe? There's the trash place again. Anyone else at the corner? And no, never mind. Okay. Now we can go to the main hall. I wish I could move faster. I hate it when I run into those walls. Oh, come on. Whoops. Okay, so we need to go this way. To the proper way of going to the second floor. If Byakuya had gone to the second floor... Wait, oh crap, that's what I forgot to look into the bathhouse. I totally forgot about that. Okay, one minute. I'm going to check the bathhouse first. Byakuya be doing. I mean, the rules did specifically say that you're not supposed to go outside of your dorms at night. Well, the bathhouse looks nice. Oh, hey, Mondo.
Yo.
How's it going? You find him? No.
Hey, come on.
Crap. Man, where the heck did he go? He got his head stuck. So far up his butt, who knows what's going on with him. I figured maybe he was taking a bath or something.
By the way...
So, what about you? You a morning bath kind of guy?
Hell yeah!
After spending all night... Whining... Dry... After spending all night with the wind in your face, there's nothing better than a morning dip. A
hot water loosens you up, and the heat of your soul gets your heart and body pumping.
Sure thing. I'll have to take your word for all that.
What?
What? You don't know what I'm talking about? Frickin' nerd.
Hell yeah.
Guy's gonna expose himself. Come with me next time. You'll see.
Okay, Mondo. I'll think about it. And I mean, it's not like I've been writing, or, you know, here in the school, right? Okay then. That was a bit unexpected. Now let's go to the second floor. I bet everyone else is here in the other hall, and trying to look for him. Okay, so there's Hifumi in the kitchen, Celeste in the dining hall, Toko and Aoi in the... near the dorm rooms. And there's Mondo in the bathhouse, and... Kiyotaka in the warehouse. Where does that leave everyone else? Where would Sakura be? Well, still nothing here. Wait. Did I see those pictures there in the first place? Wait. I thought I saw something. What is that? The mailbox. Oh. Okay. Never mind. Nothing here. I should probably check all the other rooms as well, just to be safe. Anything in the store? Oh, nothing's changed. What about the coins? I'll probably just... yeah, I'll give it a shot. Wait, how do you do this thing again? Whoops. I didn't mean to do that. Okay. I need to learn more about it first. Yeah, I should probably get going. Oh crap. Okay, don't. Okay. I'll just take a look at those balls. For now, I'll try my machine next time. I don't think Byakuya will be in the AV room. Okay, so you know what? I'm just gonna check the second floor. I'm just gonna check to see what's up there. I don't think he'll be in the gym. But yeah, I think it would be normal for Byakuya to search for clues, but would he probably do it at nighttime? I mean, if he did, that would not be a good idea. There we go.
I mean, the rule is that during nighttime, you're only allowed to sleep in the dorms, not anywhere else. Hey. Kyoko, find anything?
Hey.
So you thought to come here too? Huh?
So...
if you think about what Byakuya was so interested in yesterday, you can probably guess where he is right now, right? The library! Huh? What was it Byakuya was interested in again? What was Byakuya interested in? It could be the library. I'm gonna check that out. It might be the only obvious explanation of where Byakuya could have gone. Oh no. When I opened the door to the library and looked inside, I cried out in sudden surprise. Byakuya? What? Of all the things I had imagined, this most definitely wasn't one of them. Okay, good, he's not alive. He's not dead.
Hey,
what are you doing?
What are you doing?
I'm fishing. What does it look like I'm doing? I'm trying to read, so if you could be quiet.
I'm sorry.
Oh, sorry.
Sorry.
Wait, no!
Wait, what?
What are you doing here? Everyone's super worried. We've all been looking for you.
Yeah.
Who asked you to do that?
Because we're all supposed to meet up in the morning and eat together. We made a promise.
Yeah, don't you remember, Byakuya?
A promise?
Yeah.
Can't I get a second's peace and quiet around here?
Okay! Byakuya snapped his book shut and slowly stood up, smooth and silent as a shadow. Meanwhile, the others must have heard me yell and started showing up, one after the another.
Yo!
Byakuya! So this is where I've been hiding!
Ugh.
What the heck are you doing here, man?
Mm-hmm.
We were very concerned.
Hmm.
Well, you had no reason to be. I was just reading. I never read such a coarse novel before, but it might prove useful at some point.
Well...
what were you reading? A mystery novel. Ooh, this might be important. Byakuya was reading a mystery novel.
Wait, so are you gonna use what you're learning in there to betray us?
Don't be stupid. Yeah. It's just something to keep in mind. Okay, just something to keep in mind. Yeah, what?
Naturally.
If I decide to fight, of course. I'll come up with something original. Okay, if he decides to fight, come up something original. Otherwise, this game of ours would be totally boring, right? It's not often you get to take part in high stakes, high intention activity. So if you're gonna do it, you have to make sure it's entertaining. Make sure it's entertaining. His words sent a chill down my spine. There was an undeniable smile on his face as he spoke. He looked like he was actually enjoying himself. Acting as if he was enjoying himself. enjoying this deranged Galen game. Enjoying deranged killing game.
Damn
what
you!
What the frick do you mean game? That's messed up! But it is a game. It's a game of life or death, which can only have one winner. That's all there is to it. He is right. It's a zero-sum game. Huh?
Are you okay with this?
It's a part of a game theory. A mathematical model. A game theory. Mathematical model. In game theory, what we're going by now is called a zero-sum game. In this type of game, in order to person gain something, another must necessarily lose something. In order one person to gain something, another must lose something. And in other words, it's a situation in which participants must compete for position or resources. Okay, situation in which participants must compete for position / resources.
I see.
You mean like a kind of elimination match? Kind of elimination match.
Actually,
entrance exams, sports tournaments, job openings, most social interactions fall into this category. Everyone must scramble to obtain something which is limited. For you to succeed, someone else must fail. Okay. Everyone must scramble to obtain something limited. To succeed, someone else must fail. This is also applies to the school life that we've been subjected to here. In this case,
is that okay?
Our limited resources that only one of us can successfully become the blackened. Okay. Limited resource. Only one of us can become the blackened.
So in other words,
so this game was designed from the beginning to force one of us to try and defeat all the others. Okay. Game designed from beginning to force one try defeat all others. That can't be what they had in mind. This is why adaptation is so crucial. Those who want to escape were to disappear. And those who want to escape were to disappear, there'd be no reason to continue playing the game. Okay, if those who want to escape and disappear, no reason continue playing game.
What?
But why would I want to stop playing? It's so much fun. He smiled again as he spoke. The smile was filled with evil intent. It twisted his face into something not human. Okay, Byakuya's smile was filled evil intent. Twisted face into something not human.
It sounds as if you do not acknowledge even the possibility that you may lose, am I right?
Naturally.
Of course. You do not speak like the others. Exactly. I would expect from the Togami heir apparent. What?
Ugh. It's just normal arrogance, isn't it?
Just a second!
You talk like that, but what if you end up dead?
Not possible.
I won't. It simply isn't possible.
You son of a bitch!
Who the frick do you think you are? You know, I still just can't believe it.
What?
Believe what? An uneducated, brain-dead, useless piece of garbage like you has survived this long.
Piece of shit!
I'm gonna freaking kill you!
Don't make me repeat myself.
Like I said, I won't die.
Ugh.
You keep saying that, but... Don't bother arguing with him. For him, the concept of losing simply does not exist.
Okay.
For Byakuya... Concept... Losing does not exist.
He's the ultimate affluent progeny, after all. A boy raised to succeed from the day he was born. He considers victory his destiny and has lived his life accordingly.
He considers victory destiny.
Tests and challenges were mere ways for him to stand victorious, even if it is a life and death situation. Is that so? Is that not so, Byakuya? At least one of you seems to understand.
Isn't it wonderful?
It's because I'm the same as you. Games are meant to be won.
That's enough.
Are you trying to suggest we're on the same level? Close that vulgar mouth of yours.
Oh.
Well, I do apologize.
Anyway, let me just say this all to you. You all need to try harder. If an opponent isn't going to give it their best, where's the fun for me?
Okay, all need try harder. If opponent isn't going to give best, where's fun for me?
No.
It's a terrible way to look for it.
What?
It's because...
It isn't a game. Our life's on the line, you know? To kill your own friends is...
It's horrific.
It's horrific.
That is true, Chihiro. Friends? Who decided that?
Huh?
We're not friends. No, quite the opposite. We're in competition. We're enemies.
But,
you know...
What?
But what? Stop trying to force your contradictions. I mean, and just accept what I'm telling you.
Come on.
Yes, if you have something to say, say it. Otherwise, keep your mouth closed.
I'm sorry.
Oh, Chihiro.
Stop fucking around!
Hey! Hey, butthead! You get off on bullying people like that? Can't fight back? You want to try it on me? So you're back on pretending to be friends, huh? And how long do you think that's gonna last?
Piece of shit!
Screw you!
What?
Is that all you can say?
It's unfortunate you waste your breath on such empty gibberish.
You son of a bitch!
That's it. You're freaking dead.
Just a second.
Hold on. Just calm down.
Piece of shit!
I am calm. How is this calm? Anyway, I don't have any intention of working with the rest of you any longer. To cooperate during an elimination game is, well, frankly, a waste of time. I hate wasting my time. Waste of
time?
Not
possible.
Engaging in friendly group meals is out of the question. Someone could easily poison our food. And I'd rather not become part of the Last Supper just yet.
Duh, shit.
Quit talking like you're in a freaking movie or something!
Goodbye.
All I'm saying is that ultimately, you're all free to do whatever you want on your own. Goodbye. Okay, Byakuya. We are all free to do whatever we want on our own. Now going solo. Without a second glance back, Byakuya left. There wasn't anything we could do to keep him from going. His way of thinking was just beyond anything the rest of us could even comprehend.
But...
was he serious about all that?
He was, without a doubt.
Don't fuck with me!
Well, screw him then!
Maybe...
But what he said, he might necessarily be wrong. I mean, can you say for sure someone won't poison our food? Hey, come on, you too, Toko?
Anyway...
Oh, it's not like anyone would care even if I was gone, right? Actually, you all want me gone. You all think I'm disgusting. None of us think like that.
I'm telling
you! You just think you don't think like that. I know some people like to play the victim, but this is just totally out there. You think I don't know, but I do. You want me gone!
What the heck?
I'm not sure. The rest of you want the same thing, don't you? Hey, Toko, wait! There you go. Once she gets going like that, there's nothing you can say to bring her back. Ultimately, our breakfast meeting came to an end without answering any questions. Everyone headed back to their rooms. Jeez, I'm tired already? But I don't even have time to take an even one day off. I had to get myself going. Free time! Okay, so I'm gonna stop it here because that's all the time I have for today. Woo! We actually covered quite some ground here. I mean, Byakuya just left the group. I mean, I think everyone's going all solo. And I think because of the whole poison thing, I think people are just going to suspicion other people about poisoning food. But I don't know. Hopefully not. I hope not. But at least we have uncovered a second floor and the warehouse and the bathhouse. So we have more room to cover. So that's good. That is very good. So that's all the time I have for today for this video. So thank you everyone so much for watching. And if you like this video, you can click like, leave a comment about it, and you can share it with a friend if you want to. Be sure to check out my other Danganronpa videos. So once again, thank you everyone so much for watching. And I will see you next time. Speed Streak out.